This afternoon at County Hall, the GLC have been debating the vexed question of how big your rates bill should be. Despite massive opposition from the Conservatives, the Labour Party, led by Ken Livingston, are confident of pushing through a record budget for next year of £712 million. The budget is, according to the Tories on the council, a massive 100% increase on last year. It will cost the average ratepayer another £1.89 a week. Labour defend the increase as being a result of the Law Lords' decision to force them into scrapping London Transport's cheap fares. Let's go over now to County Hall to join Graham Addicott, who is with the leader of the GLC, Ken Livingston, and the Conservative opposition leader, Sir Horace Cutler.
Well, Mr. Livingston, first of all, a budget of £712 million, an increase on the GLC rate of almost 100%. Don't you feel that you've now let down the people that elected you to office, that the Labour Party have given up on them?
No, we've increased our expenditure by 50%. The budget we inherited from the Tories was £450 million. We've gone up to £712. And the bulk of that is to prevent a further fares increase later on in the year. The rest of it is the restoration of cuts in the fire service, money available for our industry and employment programme so we can create 10,000 jobs a year in London, and a whole range of other smaller things like keeping the rent increase down to £1 instead of £2.50, and repairing the damage there's been on after years of neglect on our estates in terms of inadequate maintenance. It's the minimum we could do in terms of complying honourably with the manifesto commitments we gave to people.
You mentioned there London Transport. Now, that's something like £125 million that you have to pay as a result of your cheap fare policy. Mm. Are you now willing to say that that cheap fare policy was a mistake and is now going to cost people more than it saved?
No. Our fares policy is a tremendous success. And if we were continuing with it now, the only difference it would make to people would be about another 40 pence a week on top of the rate bill they're going to get. Instead, they're going to have fare increases of £3-4 a week. I mean, it has been fantastically successful, and it's got another 12% of people back onto public transport. I think that is the tragedy. You could understand the Law Lords overturning the policy if it wasn't working, but it's been the most successful public transport policy for 20 years.
Sir Horace, your party's been fighting this budget tooth and nail, but if you'd been in Mr. Livingston's position, wouldn't you have done exactly the same? Can you, with your hand on your heart, say that the fares policy was a wrong thing to do?
No, I think the fares policy was fair as an experiment if it had been legal. And I think a lot of good intentions that people have turn out to be wrong in the event. It depends which way you look at it, whether you look at it from the fare payer or whether you look at it from the rate payer. And each one has got his own view. I think there's a balance between the two, which is what the Law Lords more or less pointed out that you have to observe in the fiduciary duty which we have. No, we would certainly not have put a budget forward of these proportions. We think 35 pence is a rip-off, absolute rip-off for the ratepayers, the commercial and domestic ratepayers of London. We have put forward our reason amendments and put down the figures to bring that down to 24p, which we think is enough, even taking into consideration the amount of money that London Transport have lost between October and now on giving cheap fares.
But surely Labour would say that it's your government, it's the Tory government that are forcing councils, not just Labour councils, but all councils, into this kind of budget.
Well, they are trying to, they're forcing councils to take their duties seriously in the whole of the economic sense, the national sense that is, because after all, the government are responsible for the overall national economy. But you see, what they are doing is this, even the GLC's budget, even Ken's budget, of 35 pence is attracting £44 million of grant. So that what we have done is lowered the precept so that the grant goes up. And as you do that, step by step, so that you can get down to this figure, which we've done precisely.
And where do you think we're heading then?
Well, I don't know where we're heading. This is a lot of money, £275 extra out of the ratepayers, out of London's pocket. Means that you're taking it out of the economy of London and it's going into revenue spending. That doesn't do London any good in the investment sense in the long term.
But all these things actually regenerate the London economy. We will be aiming to create more industry and enterprise through the board that we're setting up, 10,000 new jobs, by actually restoring the cuts in the fire brigade. You cut down on the loss from fire damage. You actually provide a better level of service. You take people off the dole queues. And our tragedy is that, yes, the rates are appallingly high in London. That's because London's lost about £400 million of grant which it should be getting, Labour and Tory councils in London. If we had a fair share of resources in London, there wouldn't be a rate increase this year. There'd most likely be a rate reduction. As it is, even after all that's gone on, we're still heading, I think, for most probably the lowest rate increase for 4 years, but we're starting from too high a base.
Now, you well, said
I must take up the lowest rate increase of 4 years. Mm. It's 90%. And in 4 years, over 4 years, it was only 45% in our 4 years.
Now, I'm talking in terms of what Londoners will actually pay for their borough and everything else. And I think what's happened is the outcry has tended to prevent the government making further penalties this year. But we've not got back what they've taken in previous years. And if we could get that back, that would regenerate the London economy. You could bring the rates down without crushing the services.
Now, we've heard a lot in the debates, both yesterday and today, Soros, about whose fault this is. You know, the Conservatives blaming Labour, Labour blaming central government. Haven't we got to the point now where the GLC is not serving the people of London? It can no longer perform any function.
Well, I'd say this. I think the GLC has lost a good deal of its credibility, if not all of it, and therefore its very purpose is coming into question. That's a good thing. I like it's healthy to have that sort of atmosphere.
But under any administration, no, whether you were in power
yes,
or
I know, but what I'm going to say is this, and I've said it before in public, I think the GLC under its present form is wrong. I don't think it's ever achieved its strategic or its regional strategic, the base that it should have done. I think we're involved in things we shouldn't be, and we're not doing things we ought to be doing. And it is a different metropolitan authority that I would like to see instead of the GLC.
Mr. Livingston, can the GLC do anything?
They're only talking about getting rid of the GLC because for the first time in living memory, the GLC's done something that's popular. We brought fares down, we've started improving public transport. And that's what the Tory government's terrified of. We are proving that you can have radical socialist policies and they work. That's why they want to destroy us.
No, the 1977 elections, they were abolished the GLC candidates. They came nowhere.
Gentlemen, thank you very much indeed.